No expense.
No.
And again, this is coming up March 18th. That is tomorrow night, Friday, and then again on Sunday?
That's correct.
And what are the show times, Ann?
8 p.m. on March 18th and 3 p.m. on March 20th.
One evening and one matinee.
Right.
The Bartered Bride, the current production of the Madison Civic Opera. Ann Alley, I'm sure it's going to be a great success for you.
Thank you very much,
and
Peter.
Hope you survive the next 3 days.
I hope so, too.
Bye-bye now.
Bye-bye.
At WIBA, it's 24 after 7 o'clock on St. Patty's Day.
Lawyers recommend that their clients look before they sign, and they'll often add, sign before you act. They know that a properly drawn contract will often save the kind of heartbreak that occurred in the case of the frustrated photographer. Today's Point of Law.
Now it's time for Point of Law, brought to you by O'Malley's Farm Cafe in Wanakee.
Marshall Mason had been a camera bug as a boy. He took photography courses in high school and college, and he knew his field thoroughly. He tried to get a job in a first-class store. You need a strong heart, you know you need a strong heart, yeah.
Substantial penalty for early withdrawal. The M&I Bank of Madison, member FDIC.
WIBA News Time, 7:30.
Good morning. This is Bob Bankle.
And I'm Bill Graff with the WIBA Morning News Edition. It's 33 degrees and cloudy with some fog in the Madison area. The Weather Command forecast follows the news.
In the headlines, Board of Education President Salter reacts to charges of segregation at Franklin Elementary.
Madison's mayoral candidates talked to Dane County Democrats last night.
A nuclear freeze resolution is stymied by House Republicans.
Redwood and Ross, private label difference. So pay us a visit. We'll show you the difference between spending and investment spending. Redwood and Ross.
There's a Redwood and Ross store at Westtown Mall in Madison.
14 before 8 o'clock at WIBA, along with Peter B. and the Breakfast Bunch. Brian Mathias Sports being brought to you by Panetti Yamaha. And you are about set to get dribbled to death, aren't you?
It's going to be another enjoyable weekend of basketball, you bet.
Season comes to a close, finally.
That's just it. After that, it's all over. We get a mass dose of it this weekend, and next week you look for more, and it's not there.
An overdose.
Yeah, maybe. 16 very proud school districts in the state of Wisconsin will live and die a little bit with each bucket at the Fieldhouse this weekend. It is the climax of March Madness, the WIAA State Boys High School Basketball Tournament. One of the euphoric school districts is located immediately west of Madison in the city of Middleton. It's the first trip to the final since 1955 for the Middleton Cardinals. Their Class A quarterfinal opponent tonight at 7:05 is the Milwaukee Tech Trojans. Middleton head coach Dennis Morgan hopes to stifle the high-scoring Milwaukee club.
They're a very quick type ball club. I think they'll be very much like Madison Memorial. They like to run. They like to press all over, and they are the leading offensive team going into the state tournament, averaging 68 points a game, and defensively they're giving up 58, but they won the Milwaukee Area Conference League, and we know right now they're going to be strong, and hopefully that game with Memorial is going to give us some confidence going into that ball game. And, you know, it really sometimes doesn't come down to who the opponent is. You've just got to play the type of basketball that got you there.
The Cardinals have a serious weapon of their own in junior guard Dave Zing. He's averaging 19.5 points per game as the team's point guard.
He's a very smart, intelligent type player, excellent one-on-one player, but also a great team player. He's a quiet, confident leader. He's a 3.9 grade point average, which certainly doesn't hurt him.
5 years in Canada with the Edmonton Eskimos. They'd like to, again, bolster that running back position with a few injuries they've had in the past. And so this year, again, already thinking some Packer football, Peter.
All right, as you head out to the field house, do you think maybe they'll serve green hot dogs today in honor of St. Patty's?
They usually do, St. Patty's. No, I shouldn't say that about the folks at the field house. No, I doubt it. I wouldn't eat them.
They're not green normally, are they?
Well, yeah, most of the time they're not.
Well, have a good time at the field house.
That's right. I forgot to mention dessert. Yes. You know, you have your buy it or bag it, so the school lunch menus.
Mm-hmm.
I forgot dessert. It's the Mighty Malts with the nifty little wooden spoons.
So the entire menu at the field house is Coke, hot dog,
side dish of popcorn, and then the dessert is the Mighty Malt.
Going to be ill.
Yeah, real quick.
Excuse me. 6 before 8 o'clock.
Need an extra color TV for your kids' room or for the basement or for video games or for a home computer? American has sale priced a color TV for $188 and black and white portables for $50.
And the current weather service temperature, 35 degrees. It could be worse. Bill Graff, WIBA News.
It really isn't springtime yet, Bill. Not till Monday.
Oh, not technically.
Monday is the first official day of spring. But we all know what happened last year after spring arrived. We had a couple of good snowstorms.
This happens quite frequently in Wisconsin. Election day is something that a lot of us news people always remember, and I can't remember an April election when there hasn't been some snow around.
Oh, really? I understand also that with the coming of the boys' basketball tournament, snow should be arriving. That's what the sports department says over the weekend.
That's another reliable indicator.
So, and also, I've got this pain in my left foot. There's another reliable indicator.
And, of course, there's always Weather Command. Well, and they know a thing or two about it, too.
They use the pain in their feet as well in the boys' basketball tournament to predict the weather.
Is that
it? We all use the same instruments. At WIBA 13 after 8 o'clock, I'll have all the news from the garbage can in just 1 minute.
What makes Madison work? You do. We do. All of us together.
Madison works because Madison people care enough to get involved in their neighborhoods. I'm Billy Freilinger. I see the effectiveness of that volunteer spirit every day.
I'm Mary Louise Simon, and I've seen people like you give thousands of hours of your time serving on commissions and boards.
I'm Sue Herbst. Madison works because Madison government is really all of us, not just one of us telling the rest of us what's good for us.
I'm Betty Smith. Madison works because of people like Toby Reynolds.
I'm Ollie Ashman, and I'm supporting Toby Reynolds for mayor because I've watched him serve Madison through 20 years of public service.
I'm Otto Feske. Toby's involvement began when I was mayor.
And continued through my administrations and Mayor Skornicka's years. He's far and away the most qualified because he's worked for Madison for 20 years. I'm Paul Soglin, urging you to join all of us in electing Toby Reynolds mayor.
These endorsements were sponsored by Reynolds for Mayor, Scott Herrick, Treasurer.
14 past 8 o'clock at WIBA with your breakfast buddy, Peter B. It is Thursday, March 17th, 76th day of the year. We have 289 days left. Is today a special day? Sure it is. St. Patty's Day. This is the news they refuse to use, by the way. St. Patty's Day commemorates the patron saint of Ireland, Bishop Patrick, who in 432 A.D. left his home in England and introduced Christianity into Ireland. St. Patrick was English. Did you know that? Also, today is a holiday. According to the Every Day is a Holiday calendar, it is Rubber Band Day because the rubber band was patented on this day in 1845. On this day in 1919, Nat King Cole was born. Also born on this day, Mercedes McCambridge, the actress, born in 1918, and Rudolf Nureyev, the ballet dancer. He is 45 today. On this day in 1905, Anna Eleanor Roosevelt married her fifth cousin, Franklin Delano Roosevelt, in New York City. In 1940, on this day, a ring of professional killers known as Murder Incorporated was uncovered in Brooklyn. In 1975, the first doctor's strike in U.S. history occurred in New York City when 3,000 hospital residents and interns walked off the job. They returned to work 3 days later. But the big news in the news they refuse to use comes from Detroit, the story of a very persistent con man. A clergyman thought he had avoided being taken by a con man, but the con man evened the score to the tune of $40. The Reverend Kenneth Kettlewell, pastor of First Presbyterian Church, told police he got a call Sunday morning from a man identifying himself as Father John Nader of St. Mary's. The caller said a man was on his way to Kettlewell's church and was to be given $53, after which Father Nader would repay Father Kettlewell. A check with Nader's church showed he was away for the weekend, so when the man showed up for the 53 buckaroonies, Kettlewell told the man to go back to St. Mary's. He thought, well, that's that. And he congratulated himself on not being taken. But he got another call, this time from a man identifying himself as a Sergeant Tamarask of the Detroit Police. The caller said police were trying to arrest the same man, catch him in the act. And Kettlewell was to give the man four $10 bills while three squad cars waited outside the church. Sure enough, the man comes back, Kettlewell said. I give him the money, and away he goes. But I looked out the window, and no squad cars could I see. And a check with police showed there was no Sergeant Tamarask, either. I caught the guy the first time around, but he got me on the rebound, said Father Kettlewell. The persistent con man got himself $40 the hard way. And there it is, all the news they refused to use on this Thursday morning, St. Patty's Day, March 17th, 1983.
You're rolling at the Environmental Protection Agency. A pattern is emerging which shows the agency isn't doing its job. This is Jack Anderson on Mutual Radio in Washington. I'll have the inside story after this.
Jack Anderson is brought to you by Ford medium and heavy-duty trucks and by Ford Tractors and your Ford Tractor dealer, home of America's tractor values.
Ford's got the power to save you money with a big cash allowance program on new 83 Ford medium and heavy trucks. Ford is giving its dealers special allowances which they can pass on to qualified retail buyers. And that can mean sizable savings for you on these big, tough Fords. But you must order by April 30th. See your dealer now for complete details.
Ford's got the power for today. Ford's got the power.
$99.50. Save up to 50% on distinctive Delmar woven wood blinds, and you'll get an additional $10 energy credit from Delmar. You'll save it finer, too, on Delmar vertical and wood blinds, as well as soft light shades. All wallpaper is reduced one-fourth, and you'll like the friendly assistance of creative interior decorators. Finer is open Wednesday and Friday evenings, and you know...
Finer is the finest. Come home to
It's the wonderful window and wall decorating sale now at Finer Furniture in the heart of Cross Plains.
Your breakfast buddy, Peter B., keeping you company at 21 past 8 on WIBA. Always big goings on downtown on St. Patty's Day at the Civic Center today. The noontime concert has to do with St. Pat, I'm sure. I've called Jennifer Fisk at the Civic Center this morning. Hello, Jennifer.
Good morning, Peter. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
And the top of the morning to you, too.
Oh, thanks.
Drinking some green tea?
Yes, it's too early for green beer.
I never have been able to down a green beer. Just looking at it kind of turns my stomach upside down. I can't bear it.
Well, we won't have any of that down at the Civic Center today.
No, so what will you have at the Civic Center today?
This afternoon at noontime, our Concerts in the Crossroads series is going to present a band called Lunasa, which is a local band composed of 2 to 3 people. It changes every now and then.
Depending on who wakes up that morning,
exactly,
right?
Exactly, who's up at that hour. Who performed traditional Irish music on traditional Irish instruments. And it should be a good way for people to kick off their St. Patrick's Day celebration. No green beer at noon, unfortunately, but you can start celebrating a little early at noon.
What are the traditional Irish instruments?
There are all sorts of them. There are a set of pipes, which are similar to bagpipes, but they're smaller, which sound similar to bagpipes. They're called the Eland pipes, I believe is how you pronounce it. The tin whistle, of course, which is kind of like a recorder, a penny whistle.
Uh-huh.
There's a drum called a boran, which is a goatskin hollow-back drum, which is played with a mallet that is flicked with the wrist. It's a very difficult and interesting technique, I suppose you'd call it, to play a boran, and provided that Lunasa brings one with them, it should be a real treat to watch someone play that.
How long will this concert run?
The concert will begin at noon and will run probably until about 1 o'clock. These concerts usually last about an hour, so people can come and eat lunch, grab a cup of coffee, and enjoy some good music.
Is it indoors?
Yes, it is. It's in the Crossroads Performance Area at the Civic Center, which is just inside the State Street doors. There's plenty of bleacher seating, and fresh air will probably be streaming in through the doors as people come in.
It's going to be kind of a brisk day today, 35 degrees now, maybe around 40 at noontime.
Yeah, I hope it's cold enough to get people out and in, but not cold enough to keep them in their offices.
This is part of a continuing series, isn't it?
It certainly is. This series has been going on since September. This is our second year of Concerts in the Crossroads. And the series continues through the end of May this year. May 26th will be our final concert for this season. And I'm sure we'll be starting up again next September, too.
I think it's a great thing to have downtown for people at lunchtime.
It's a lot of fun. It's become part of a lot of downtowners' weekly schedules. They make sure to come down and catch what's happening in the Crossroads every Thursday, because every Thursday it is something different going on. For instance, next week we'll have neoclassical dance going on, which should be very interesting.
What do you have coming up in the Crossroads over the next few weeks? Any special events?
The next few weeks we'll present previews of a dance concert next Thursday. The M.M. Colbert Dance Company, which is a local Madison dance company, is performing in the Isthmus Playhouse next weekend, and we've asked them to come preview some of their pieces next Thursday in the Crossroads at noon. And on March 31st, we're very proud to be co-sponsoring with the National Organization for Women a tribute to women artists. We'll be featuring Lynette, who's going to be writing some special music and singing some music either written or made famous by women, and we're very proud to be including women as a special group in this series.
Well, you have a lot of special events coming up then.
Sure do, always. Something's always going on at the Civic Center.
And today at noontime, it is Irish music in the Crossroads.
You got it.
Jennifer Fisk, happy St. Patty's Day.
Same to you, Peter. Thank
Bye-bye.
You.
System smile on your face. Oh, hey, good looking, you got it. You got that new dress system smile.
Get that Nutrisystem smile started today and save a full one-third off your program cost. The Nutrisystem Weight Loss Medical Center program is a safe, rapid approach to weight loss. Find out just how simple it is to lose that weight with Nutrisystem. Call for a free, no-obligation consultation. Schedule it anytime you want. As long as you call before 5 p.m. Friday, you'll be eligible for the one-third off price. Call Nutrisystem West in Madison at 833-4500 or Nutrisystem East in Madison, 221-8383. Or call Nutrisystem in Janesville at 752-4644. Do it now and you'll save one-third. The last diet you'll ever be on is Nutrisystem.
Buy a TV, get a bike. Buy an appliance, get a bike. Buy a stereo, get a bike.
You know the routine, and it's a great idea. Only the Appliance Mart takes it a step further. Now you have a choice. You don't have to settle for just any bike. At the Appliance Mart, we'll give you a choice of two quality bikes, included with thousands of items. Bikes with a name you'll recognize immediately. A bike that sells locally for $179.
A premier racing bike with 12-speed wide-range gearing, aerodynamically designed frame and components, array of lightweight aero rims with gum wall tires, genuine suede leather saddle, famous Shimano front and rear derailleur, Shimano center parapool brakes.
Or a BMX dirt bike with advanced design frame and tubular fork, black stagger block tires, V-line handlebars, full pad kit, the absolute best in BMX styling, fully assembled to factory specifications by service technicians. It isn't just any bike. Now you have a choice.
A quality BMX dirt bike or a super 12-speed racing bike.
Included with thousands of items now at the Appliance Mart.
It's 27 after 8 o'clock on WIBA. It is the Clancy Brothers.
Well, here I am from Paddy's land, a land of high renown. I broke the hearts of all the girls for miles from Katy Town. And when they hear that I'm a war, they'll raise a hullabaloo. When they hear about that handsome lad that they call O'Donoghue. Well, I'm the boy to please her, and I'm the boy to tease her. I'm the boy can squeeze her, and I'll tell you what to do. I'll court her like an Irishman with a brogan Blarney to his me plan with me rollickin', smolligin', holligin', walligin', bold O'Donoghue. I wish me love was a red, red rose grown on yon garden wall. And me to be a dew dropping upon her brow I fall. Perhaps now she might think on me as a rather heavy dew. No more she'd love that handsome lad that they call O'Donoghue. Her, I'm the boy to please her, and I'm the boy to tease her. I'm the boy can squeeze her, and I'll tell you what to do. I'll court her like an Irishman with a brogan Blarney to his me plan with me rolligin', smolligin', holligin', walligin', bold O'Donoghue. I hear that Queen Victoria has a daughter fine and grand. Perhaps she take it into her head for to marry an Irishman. And if I could only get the chance to have a word or two, Hey! Sure she take a notion in the bowl out on her.
Hey!
I'm the boy to please her, and I'm the boy to tease her. I'm the boy can squeeze her, and I'll tell you what to do. I'll court her like an Irish man with a brogan blarney to his feet, man with me rollicking, smolligan, holligan, walligan, bowl out on her.
Hey, the Clancy Brothers. Bit of Irish music on St. Patty's Day.
Dateline, spring at Easttown Mall, where now through Sunday there are more savings throughout the mall on spring fashions. It's all part of Easttown's Dateline Spring of Values. You'll also see more of the latest spring fashions during Easttown's Spring Fashion Shows, Friday at 7 p.m. and Saturday at 1 p.m. in Center Court. Easttown's Dateline Spring of Values, from the only shopping center that has more of everything you want. Easttown Mall, East Washington Avenue and I-94.
Here spending the morning along with Peter B. and the Breakfast Bunch, WIBA News Time is 8:30.
Good morning, I'm Bob Banco, WIBA News. It is cloudy with a touch of fog in the Madison area. The temperature is 35 degrees. This news a service of F.E. Siebold. The personal attacks that have dominated the past few days of the Madison mayor's campaign were nowhere in evidence last night as candidates Toby Reynolds and Joseph Sensenbrenner fielded questions from Dane County Democrats. It was back to the issues as the candidates covered everything from the South Beltline to landlord-tenant relations. Sensenbrenner said he didn't have a strong preference on the two Beltline alternatives. Reynolds strongly favors the existing route. And both men agreed that there should be some kind of a mediation panel for landlords and tenants, but not exactly like the old Rental Relations Board. Reynolds brought up what he called a scandal in the city health department over the disposal of hazardous chemicals, and he said that if what he's heard is true, Health Director Patrick Kennedy should be fired.
But it shouldn't be a newspaper that has to fire the man. Somebody ought to have been looking at him, following the conduct. I believe that if you've got a strong mayor who knows what he is and knows who they are, and like any good supervisor, follows up on the conduct of their work, you don't need to worry about structure. You don't need to worry about four-year terms. You don't need to worry about people being appointed. The man ought to have been fired if what he did was, what he was reported to have done is correct.
That comment came in response to a question about the role of department heads in city government, which Sensenbrenner answered by calling for a four-year term for mayor.
When I worked for Pat Lucy for 4 years in the governor's office, it was very apparent those agencies that had cabinet heads, and Pat could get on the phone or ask me to get on the phone and say, this is what we need, this is what we want to do, and those agencies which weren't. And as time becomes of the essence in capturing development dollars and moving ahead for the city, I think it's going to be in Madison's best interest to strengthen the authority of the mayor in order to get the kind of decisions made, not necessarily right, left, or right, yes or no, but kind of get a decision from the city departments as they consider the matters that come before them.
Both candidates said they could support the concept.
Little leprechauns along, too, for a bowl of Mrs. Murphy's chowder. Don't you think you'd like to celebrate St. Patrick's Day at O'Malley's Farm Cafe? We have a taste of Irish in our kitchen.
O'Malley's Farm Cafe in Wanakee.
23 before 9 o'clock. Are you set for some more green trivia? Haven't done this since really early this morning. Just after 6 o'clock, we had the first green trivia question. Where's my trivia list? You can win yourself a $5 gift certificate from Felly's Flowers if you know the answer here. By the way, the number is 291-6422. All right, and I won't take the first caller. I'll wait till all the lines light up and then just pick one at random. Where's my question? Number three. Okay. A sports green question. This is called the Green Monster. What is the Green Monster? Do you know? 291-6422 is the number. All lines are lighting up at once, just like I thought they would. Pick this line over here. Hello, you're on with Peter B.
Good morning.
Good morning, top of the morning. Happy St. Patty's.
Yeah, I'm German, but that's all right. It's green anyway.
You know what the green monster is?
A dragon?
No. This is a sports question.
Oh.
What is the green monster? You don't know.
A sports question?
Yeah, what is the green monster? Come on.
Oh, boy.
You're not a sports fan, huh?
Yeah.
You are? Are you a baseball fan?
Oh, baseball?
Yeah?
Yes.
Well, the green
definitely
monster...
Definitely Brewers.
The green monster is nothing. Has nothing at all to do with the Brewers. Nothing.
Okay. All right. Well, I'll give somebody else a chance.
Okay. Sorry. Bye-bye. Take another line. Hi, what's the green monster?
Fenway Park, the wall in left field.
That's right. I'm glad you called in.
Well, I am, too.
The green monster is not a fire-breathing dragon.
Right.
It is the left field fence. Who am I speaking with?
Paul Weber.
Oh, you were a qualifier yesterday.
In 2 seconds.
Yeah, in the Brewer Trip to California contest.
Right.
Well, Paul, you've won yourself a $5 gift certificate from Felly's Flowers. Hold on so I can get your address.
My wife will love that.
I'll bet she will. Get her a green carnation.
I will.
Okay.
Your bank is only as good as the people in it.
I know which Madison Bank has one of the best investment and financial advisory programs available. I know because I help run it. I'm Marilyn Popkowitz, investment officer at Randall Bank. Here at Randall Bank, we pride ourselves on being a community-based, independent bank. We help make investment decisions based on what's best for you, and we've been doing that for over 60 years. Give me or any of our other investment professionals a call. Let's talk about your financial goals. Really talk. We'll help you with your immediate needs and help plan your future, too. We're ready to demonstrate that the words personal, professional service mean something, at least at Randall Bank.
Randall Bank, 1720 Monroe Street, Madison. Member FDIC.
20 before 9 o'clock, Brian has another green trivia question, but we have no prize now.
No prize?
No prize to give away. No prize.
This one's a tougher one, too.
This is a freebie.
Every year on March 17th at spring training, there's one team that gets rid of their usual uniforms, their usual colors, and they replace their main color with green. Green caps and green trim on the white uniforms, green lettering, all of that.
They do.
Just once a year they bring it out on St. Patrick's
Day. Does it have the team name on it and everything?
It's a regular uniform.
Really?
In fact, last year I saw video on ESPN or something from St. Patrick's Day, and I thought there was something wrong with my set. Because it looked identical, but they were green instead of red.
The Chicago White Sox.
No.
No?
It's a team you expect to wear green, not expect to wear green.
California Angels.
Even though their manager was Irish. Last year, I believe he was Irish.
Billy Martin was an Irish.
No.
You've got
Cincinnati
me here.
Reds.
The Cincinnati Reds.
Cincinnati Reds.
Johnny McNamara.
Johnny. I should have known
there
that.
There you go, the Reds. Why, yeah, right.
Today they're the Cincinnati Greens.
Yep. That's why I really thought there was something wrong with the set when I turned it on and saw the Reds wearing green.
While she lay sleeping, I stay out late at night and play my songs. And sometimes all the nights can be so long. And it's good when I finally make it home all alone. While she lays dreaming, I try to get undressed without the light. And quietly she says, how was your night? And I come to her and say, it was alright. And I hold her tight. And she told her someday if she was my girl, I could change the world with my little songs, I was wrong. But she has faith in me, and so I go on trying faithfully. And who knows, maybe on some special night, if my song is right, I will find a way, while she lays waiting. I stumble to the kitchen for a bite. Then I see my old guitar in the night, just waiting for me like a secret friend. And there's no end while she lays crying. I fumble with a melody or two, then I'm torn between the things that I should do. Then she says to wake her up when I am through. God, her love is true. And she believes in me. I'll never know just what she sees in me. I told her someday, if she was my girl, I could change the world with my little songs. I was wrong. But she has faith in me, and so I go on trying faithfully. And who knows, maybe on some special night, if my song is right, I will find a way. While she waits for me.
She believes in me on St. Patty's Day. That is Kenny Rogers, 15 before 9 o'clock. And you're spending time with Peter B. and the Breakfast Bunch. More green trivia coming up this morning after 10 o'clock. Tim Brickner will have a couple of green trivia questions for you. And after 9 this morning, I have the name of another possible qualifier to win that Brewer's trip to California.
Joe Sensenbrenner, decisive on the issues.
Madison's greatest challenge is economic development. We need a plan to promote small business, to be creative in fostering traditional development projects, to capitalize on the potential of high tech, and we need a defensive strategy. I'm prepared to meet these challenges. I have the experience and ability to keep Madison strong.
Joe Sensenbrenner for mayor. Strong, decisive, a leader for Madison. Authorized and paid for by Sensenbrenner for mayor, Bill Berry, treasurer.
At Zimbrick Used Cars, we have the quality to go with our name. We can assure you of the finest cars, the best selection, and of course the traditional Zimbrick service and customer care. A 23-year record in South Central Wisconsin. All of our used cars are clean and properly serviced, from the hood to the trunk. They're offered to you at prices we think you'll like. Economy Corner, Isuzu, and Zimbrick Used Cars on the Beltline at Fish Hatchery Road.
Newsbreak, Charles Osgood, CBS News.
I can see the horses drawing the caisson. And most generally, folks have...
Made it through the rain. That's Barry Manilow, 11 after 9 o'clock. Peter B. and the Breakfast Bunch in your Thursday morning. I was kind of wondering aloud last week, wondering if Barry Manilow had ever appeared in town in Madison, and I guess he has never appeared as a solo performer, but a listener called and said, yeah, Barry was here at one time when Bette Midler was in town. When Bette was here performing, Barry Manilow was her piano player and her orchestra leader very early in his career. She also let him do one number, let him sing one song. I guess he was quite good. That must have been, oh, gee, about 10 years ago when he was here as part of Bette Midler's troupe. That has been a while. It's 11 after 9, turning out to be a pretty fair-looking morning. Partly sunny now.
Ladies and gentlemen, for your entertainment pleasure, Madison Civic Opera and Madison Symphony Orchestra proudly present The Bartered Bride, a light-hearted comic opera in three spectacular acts. Two fabulous performances, Friday, March 18th, Sunday, March 20th, at the Oscar Mayer Theater.
The Bartered Bride by Bedřich Smetana is a fanciful and festive look at the world of the Bohemian village square of the 19th century. A world of lively dancing, lovely folk songs, and young lovers matching wits with a wily marriage broker. The opera stars Daniel Nelson, Carol Gutkonecht, Arnold Vokatitis, and a cast of hundreds. Produced and stage directed by Arlene Johnson, with Rollin Johnson conducting. Tickets are $10, $15, $19, and $23 at the Civic Center box office, or call in charge, 266-9055.
Get that Nutrisystem Smile started today and save a full one-third off your program cost. The Nutrisystem Weight Loss Medical Center program is a safe, rapid approach to weight loss. Find out just how simple it is to lose that weight with Nutrisystem. Call for a free, no-obligation consultation. Schedule it anytime you want. As long as you call before 5 p.m. Friday, you'll be eligible for the one-third off price. Call Nutrisystem West in Madison at 833-4500 or Nutrisystem East in Madison, 221-8383. Or call Nutrisystem in Janesville at 752-4644. Do it now and you'll save one-third. The last diet you'll ever be on is Nutrisystem.
Play ball.
Now it's time to qualify another lucky listener for a chance to win a trip for two to the Brewers opening game in Anaheim, California.
Looking for a perfect record this week. So far, all the names I've read have called in to qualify. Kathy Marty of Openwood Way in Madison. Kathy Marty, Openwood Way in Madison. It's your turn to qualify. You must call in the next 13 minutes and 10 seconds, and then we'll put your name in the drawing for that grand prize, a trip to California to see the Brewers take on the Angels on opening day in Anaheim. Kathy Marty, your 13 minutes and 10 seconds has already begun. So call in, please. I want to keep my record intact. I've been perfect this week. Quarter after 9 at WIBA. Here's Mary McGregor.
There are times when a woman has to say what's on her mind, even though she knows how much it's gonna hurt. Let me hold you close and say these words as gently as I
don't think you failed me just because there's someone else. You were the first real love I ever had. And all the things I ever said, I swear they still are true. For no one else can have the part of me.
Between two muggers. That is Mary McGregor. That's kind of an Irish song, isn't it? No, Scottish, I suppose. McGregor, that's Scottish. 18 after 9 o'clock. Had a qualifier in the Brewer Trip to California contest. Kathy Marty. Hi, Kathy.
Hi.
I think you might have broken the record set yesterday by Paul Weber.
Oh, good.
He called in, I think, in 3 seconds, and you may have beat him by about a half second.
Yeah, I was calling. I was dialing while you were still saying my name.
Really? You're just sitting by the phone, patiently waiting for your name to be called.
Well, I had to stay home today with a sick child, so
oh.
I'm taking it a little easy. And I thought, oh, I'll listen, and I hope you say my name. I hope I didn't miss it.
What's wrong with the child?
Oh, she's got the flu.
Oh, no, I hope you don't get it.
So do I. I want to win that trip.
Well, you have a good chance, I suppose. You're in the drawing now.
Good.
We'll draw out the name over the weekend, announce the winner on Monday morning.
Okay, I'll be listening.
And if it's you, we'll call you.
Good.
Okay?
Okay, thank you.
Congratulations on qualifying. You'll get a letter and a small prize from WIBA in the mail real soon.
Okay, thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Get great savings now on drapes, blinds, bedspreads, and wallpaper at the Finer Furniture Store in Cross Plains. Finer Furniture, the complete home decorating and furnishing store, is featuring...
Whack him with a shillelagh. Peter B. and the Breakfast Bunch on WIBA. WIBA News Time is 9:30.
Good morning. I'm Bob Banco with this WIBA News Update. The 38,000-member Wisconsin Farm Bureau Federation says the typical Wisconsin dairy farm...
Editors of the Wall Street Journal at 10:35 this morning. For WIBA News, I'm Bob King.
I bet you're ready for... Buffalo Bob, the morning embarrassment on St. Patty's Day.
So you got a green sweater on.
Yeah, green sweater. I got green pants. I got green socks. My shoes aren't green. My underwear is kind of off, it's off-white. But I'm ready.
The only thing green on me is the underside of my, what I thought was a gold watch band.
Oh, you were taken again. Here it is, the morning embarrassment, Buffalo Bob. This was called in by a listener this morning who said, you've got to use this on Bob today.
Sure.
Sure, okay. Did you ever watch The Waltons TV show?
Only when I was forced to.
Under protest.
Right.
I like The Waltons, really. But
the you Walton saw one, show. You saw them all, really.
Probably. Good night, Mary Ellen.
Right.
Night, John.
John Boy, that's right, John Boy.
Who cuts the grass on Walton's Mountain? Who cuts the grass on Walton's Mountain?
John Boy's lawn boy.
He got it.
Is that right?
Well, the answer was simply lawn boy. You went a bit too far.
See, and I didn't. If I'd have watched the show, I'd have never got that.
Score 1 point for the news director this morning.
Benny Hill jokes.
If you're a successful businesswoman who wants to aid some poor unfortunate overseas, you can help support a third world child for about $18 a month. We don't, however, see any sense in your helping support some rich fashion designer in Paris. And that's just what you're doing when you subject yourself to the latest whims and fads in women's clothing. Instead, we suggest you investigate Redwood and Ross. Our women's shops feature fine quality traditional clothing that won't look silly or outdated 2 years from now. It's also the kind of clothing you'll see worn by the most successful women in businesses and boardrooms across the land. And our clothing is reasonably priced, thanks to the Redwood and Ross private label difference. So strike a blow for freedom, and let all those fashion designers find some honest work for a change. Redwood and Ross, for women.
There's a Redwood and Ross store for women at Westtown Mall in Madison.
Lawn boy. He got it. I don't believe it. Thought that was a tough one.
Until you've been beside a man.